So, you want to level fast in Torchlight Infinite? Well, I recently won a boss race event, and then you can see the results there. I came in first by quite a large margin, and I'll show you a little bit how I did that and give you some quick tips and tricks. So, first, what you're going to want to do, you're just always going to want to be moving. I mean, it is as simple as it sounds. You're gonna want to keep moving. As you run through the zone, don't kill too many packs, but if you leap into a pack of monsters, you can just hit them down real quick. Hopefully you have damage. So I won't clear the whole thing. You can see I just jump, clear what's there. And then keep going. Don't get too caught up on clearing any one thing. I wouldn't really stop to kill any rares that are there. Your main priority is getting to the boss of the map. And as you can see, the boss gives you a lot of XP compared to the little mobs, which is why you don't really want to focus on the little mobs too much. You just want to leap slam through if there's a pack right in front of you. You can clear it, but yeah. So you're gonna wanna clear bosses while leveling. As in to go back and farm them repeatedly in certain zones. So if you're clearing the axe, and you get to a certain area where the boss is relatively close to the start of the map, you can go back and click the zone and click reset stage. For example, that one, what you do is you just click reset stage, and then what I just did, and you go to the right to the boss at the end. I'll give you a few examples here of some good ones for lower level. King's Pass is good. So what you do is you do the zone once, your first clear. You click reset stage, and then you teleport back in, and it'll reset the zone, and the boss and everything will be there still. So basically, and while you're leveling as well, if you click the story quest on the side, it will tell you where to go. It'll put little diamonds on the ground, and then you can follow those, and it shows you exactly where you need to go, so you don't need to memorize the layouts or anything. Obviously, I don't have access to it right here, so I'm kind of just leaping around. Try and find where I need to go. But you'll come through here, and then the boss is a little bit down here. What you'll do is you just leap all the way to the end, and you'll clear him. I'm obviously overleveled, but it'll take you a little bit longer than that, but it should give you like 50% of your XP, and you clear that until you're at the zone level. You can also go a little bit further if you want, but eventually it will get diminishing returns and you won't get that much XP. Another good zone to level in, I'll just point out the first like four or so. And then it's pretty easy to tell on the way there. Just if it's pretty short to get to the boss of the zone, then you should probably farm it if you're anywhere below the zone level. So King's Pass is the first one I'd say is worth farming. And then after that, Minella is good up to, you can go to 13. You can go like one above the zone, I'd say. And then after that, you clear to Act 2. And then the Parish Courtyard is good. Another really good zone to look at is in Act 3. Sanctum of Prophecy. So after Act 3, you have to kind of start clearing more mobs. Or else you will start to fall behind, but still, you want to mainly focus on the bosses. So Sanctum of Prophecy is a really, really good catch-up spot if you're any way behind at all. So you walk down here. You have to talk to the NPC first at the start, Esmeralda, I believe. And then you click all of the trial thingies. And what you'll come down is you'll run down to this one. You want to click the bottom one first and then the top one. Well, this does. It'll spawn two packs of monsters that give you a ton of XP. It spawns a lot of little mobs, and it spawns two bosses, and it's really fast. So, if I was a lower level, I'd farm the zone for quite a few levels on this character before I got to this level. It gives you all loot, too, that you can check if you need to upgrade any of your gear as well. So, your links for your skills, you're going to want to use Leap Slam or Leap Attack. You can also use like Spiral Strike if you can't use Leap Attack, but you really want to try and fit in Leap Attack. It is really, really fast to clear maps, and you just leap all the way to the end. You want to stay away from things like Blink that have a cooldown, just because you can only use it like once a second or however long, once every 3 seconds without any cooldown reduction. But Leap Attack, you're going to want to link Quick Mobility and Periodic Burst to it. Quick Mobility just essentially makes you leap faster. Periodic Burst gives you a buff every 6 seconds that gives you more attack speed, which makes you link faster. Other two things that are good, if you're an attack-based build, Bloodthirst linked with Mania is really good, and Bull's Rage linked with Death Will is really good as well. That's just for attacks. I'm sure there's the spell equivalent as well, but for attacks, there you go. So for auras, the imbues are really good and the thunder, the spirits are really good. So whatever element you are leveling with, you will equip that respective one. Like if you're a fire skill, it would be fire imbue. And then rejuvenation is also very good early for keeping you alive. The flat life regen is very powerful. So good leveling items. Leveling items in this game are really good, specifically for one main reason. Things like jewelry, if you can see here, it says requires level 6, but the item level is 80. So what this means is if you have another character leveled already, assuming you're not a fresh start, you can get a really powerful ring from the end game, and then you can give it to your newly created characters. So this is pretty unique. So you can just equip it and then you really will blast quite hard. Some other good uniques you could use to level are like Gambler's Embrace Gloves, the Awaiting Boots. I think I have them on here. I don't have the gloves, I just have a rare pair. Desire for Survival's good for a little cheat death thing. Pale Mist is good if you're AoE. Faceless Night Maul is a good two-handed weapon. Most of the unique weapons are generally going to be better than what you pick up off the ground for early anyways. You can see the damage is just the DPS, the flat DPS is just way higher. And it also gives you special effects. So uniques are really powerful to level with. I recommend this Warhammer a lot if you're leveling a melee build. It's been quite good. And if you are fresh starting, something you can do is go over to the trader, go to the black market, and it will have some pretty okay gear. You can spend these black market, black golds on, and it gives you two rolls per, like, thing. You can choose them, and you can refresh it, and you can look if there's any, upgrades to your stuff from there, and that's helpful, and you can identify it. So it's worse than my stuff. I mean, my stuff's like leveling gear from other characters, so it'll be hard to beat. But that is a good place to look if you're fresh starting and you want to check that out. Besides that, I think that is all of the major tips. You just gotta remember to keep on moving.